welcome to Oasis at Wembley. Now, this is probably the biggest music event this side of the millennium. Now, although Noel and Liam have played almost every major venue in the world, they have yet to play at Wembley Stadium. And just look, can I just... 70,000 fans out there. It is a total Oasis frenzy. First, though, I think we should find out what the atmosphere on the floor is like from our gorgeous raving reporter. Matthew Brown is down there amongst the heaving mass of humanity. Matt, are you there?
I am, Kelly. Can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear. You're looking rather nice today, Matthew.
The atmosphere down here, Kelly, is absolutely unbelievable. These people have been here for a long time. Let's just look at them all. They seem to be under some kind of illusion that I'm a busker or something. They keep throwing coins and things in my direction. And I've got an awful lot of drink up here as well that they've very kindly provided by way of throwing it up.
Okay, now Matt, who have you seen milling around?
There's been a lot of people milling around. There are rumours that Johnny Depp is here. Rachel Hunter, we know, is in town with Mark Wahlberg, her latest beau. I was backstage with Bez, and he was telling me that he's been hanging out with Liam and Noel, and apparently all the bitterness is now over and done with. It's all in the past. All they want to do is they want to get out on that stage over there, and they want to give these fine people the concert of a lifetime.
Oh, but Matt, the bulldozers are coming in. Wembley Stadium is going to be no more. How do they feel about that?
Well, I think the fans are so excited about seeing Oasis. They're not too bothered about that. But you're right, John Bon Jovi is going to be playing here. He's going to have the last gig under the Twin Towers at Wembley Stadium. But as Noel Gallagher said, this right here, right now, is going to be the final great gig at Wembley Stadium.
Now, Matt, where are you going to be watching the concert from?
Do you know what, Kelly? I've got this. On my side, okay? This is access all areas. I'm going to be going down to the mosh pit. I'm going to be on stage, backstage. I'm going to be everywhere.
Thank you very much, Matt, and I'll see you later on.
You better believe it.
Okay, well, that's it. Just listen to the roar of the crowd. The lights are going down. Please prepare yourself for a concert of a lifetime. Now, although I have to warn you, there is going to be some bad language from the beginning because it's Oasis. It's rock and roll at the end of the day. So here, I present you Oasis from Wembley.
We'll be right back. on the mooter, but yeah, you're fucking slipping. This is for Bob Geldof. This is for fucking Simple Minds. This is for all these other fucking idiots who start. But I'm glad you made it. Fucking Live Aid. I bet you wish it was fucking free at all.
By the way, could I just say peace and love to every single person in the whole stadium? Thank you very much. This one's called Go Let It Out.
Says Lazy Ass, if you sign his back for a year. Playing all the illusion, try to play with what you got. Taste every emotion, as if you like yourself a lot. Go let it out, and go let it in, and go let it out. Pick up your face. Life is black emotions, in the most peculiar way. Since the psychosis, don't got a lot to say. We'll be right back.
Fucking Postman Park. Hey, if you're gonna do one the last time, might as well get pissed out of your ass, yeah? If anybody falls down, can you pick them straight back up, man? There's people getting hurt down there. Be nice, be nice.
Thank you. watched this football pitch, man, since I was about 3 and a half. Do you want to know what's good about it? I never fought a beer with a bunch of mates and that, having it fucking large. And I don't care about fucking, you're a rock star, you're this, you're having it fucking large. I'm playing Wembley Stadium, and I'm not, I'm doing it with my mates. Time some fucking excitement happened in this fucking shit all round. What time someone fucking done it proper?
Thank you.
game will be on in about 10 minutes. It's surely got that.
Thank you.
one's called Step Out of Anyone's Remotely Bothered. No, carry on. Fucking cheeky bunch of bastards.
Not quite if it takes though, eh?
I guess I'll come down there and join you. 8 fucking years and you're that arsed.
It's actually 9 years, but it's coming.
It's a really professional, this gig, yeah? Is it? Is it really fucking smash it? Are we having a good time? Is it really fucking pro? Fucking on, not.
Once again, I would like to express my peace and love to everybody in this building.
Listen, I dig all you, man. I dig all your offsprings. I dig all your pecs. I dig everything. I just don't like shitholes.
Pecs is a bit taken a bit far, isn't it, man? Pecs.
It's giving me a fucking bad name, man. I think it all got away, but I can't be sad. You don't want it to be professional, do you? Genesis, mate.
Hang on a minute.
Don't fucking knock Genesis. Anyone who's got a ball in the drummer looks like a twat and can sing. I'm talking about Phil Collins.
I'll do it in your bedroom. And this one's for all the alcoholics. And believe it or not, right, Nolan G's more of a pisser than I am. Ever been. So this one's for Noel.
Now, wouldn't that take some believing, eh?
You know, if there was 40 cans of beer in our house, I was getting two, you know what I mean? Which leads me nicely into the next song.
Call that losing nonsense. you boys are having a chat, discussion.
So that's still talk drugs, that's a bit paranoid as fuck now. I've been thinking Matt Dayton was going to come and kick me off for doing the fucking bit now. The mind boggles.
The way it's gonna be, yeah.
Tradition rests on the screen. Don't do the fucking service and you get your fucking stupid bird to get a breast out on the screen. Come on. Because I get a right thick hair. He's going to get kicked in the ass. So is he. So is the one. We'll be right back. scuds you off, you fucking head, man. It was really fucking good when we're on it. I was like, everyone's on it. Apologising for making so much fucking money for him.
I never have to apologise for that.
Anyway, fuck that. This one's called Tax Man.
Suspended days in the sunshine.
you. So, your first thing, Simon.
Now you might find
you very much. Cheers.
This one's a little bit, Dave. Just want to stick to your guns. You polish your bullet. Don't double that over there. I'll stand you in front of the city. All that. You've got like three babies to tell you. All respect. This one's a little bit, Dave. Live forever.
Thank you.
I'm in one of them fucking moods, you know, them moods that you're getting, you can't get out of. Really fucked up mood. It's true, I am a fucking swat.
Dedicate this next song to all the people who used to work at Creation Records. This is what it's all about.
Tracer.
song. You really fucking scared out of it. The last one tonight is called Rock and Roll Star.
I'm a rocker.
Okay, there we go, Matt. The end of the show, I don't think words can describe what we've just seen.
I'll tell you what, I've got to say, it's a moment of my life. I was right down there in the middle of them. 70,000 people giving it some.
Did you get anything thrown at you?
I got a few things thrown at me, but it's been sorted.
But the violence was more on stage, or was it?
Well, you know, that was the weird thing, was that we'd heard that they were all best pals, but there was a bit of weirdness on the stage. Were they being... There were moments when you thought that they were just being pally and a bit funny. You know, Noel told Liam that he drinks more than Noel does. But there were moments where, you know, you just thought maybe they're just bristling for a fight.
Didn't I just see Liam walk up to Noel and try and give him a kiss?
Yeah.
Look!
You thought, was he going to
give him a punch?
Was he going to give him a punch?
And then give him a kiss. And then Noel's getting a bit annoyed.
But you know what? They don't look best of pals, do they? Look at him. He's just about to give it some more.
Oh dear.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, but a crowd favourite was Supersonic. Do you remember Supersonic?
Supersonic was absolutely wonderful.
Then we can have a look at Supersonic. Now this was one of the finest moments, without a doubt.
The crowd absolutely loved it. I mean, this is one of the first songs that was released. 94, I think it came out.
I was 14. How old was you, Matt?
I daren't tell you.
A lot older than me.
A little bit. Not a lot.
I bet you don't know what was number one in 1994 in August. Prince. The most beautiful girl in the world.
But do you know, that only reached number 31 when it was released. If they were to release it now,
number one,
smash hit.
My favourite, I have to say, Wonderwall, and everyone was singing it. What must that sound like?
Wonderwall is one of the, you know, everyone reckons that whatever your favourite song is, Wonderwall is their most perfect song. And it was unbelievable. And how wonderful must it be to have 70,000 people just screaming back? Yeah, the words to it. Absolutely marvellous. That is fantastic, isn't it?
I don't know what a Wonderwall is, but that sounds good, doesn't it? And I think the girl lifting her top up got the crowd going, didn't it? You missed that bit, never mind. But I must say, Roll With It was the showstopper, wasn't it?
Now, it's one of those songs, it's perfect for a stadium because the crowd absolutely went berserk.
It's an Oasis classic.
It is an Oasis classic. It's the first Oasis song I ever bought, so it's a little bit of a personal favourite of mine. But the crowd absolutely loved it, and look at them, they're just jumping up and down, and they are giving it some.
I think the boys looked like they enjoyed that.
I think they did. Yeah, this was one of the moments where they seemed quite pally. Absolutely fantastic.
There you go.
That's what it's all about.
All in all, a fantastic concert.
And I was down there.
I know. I was up here. Well, thank you very much, Matt.
No problem.
I think it's been
a
fantastic evening. Thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we've enjoyed bringing it to you. So good night and God bless.
Anyone spot Robbie in the crowd then? Now, what about Nicole? Oh, well. America's dumbest criminals are here next.